we'll do is we'll just continue with Umesh's presentation and we'll come back to this.
All right, so Poshita is taking some more time for getting ready. Because it's a Bharatanatyam performance, she needs to adorn herself with the required paraphernalia, so it's taking some time. But let's proceed forward. So what I'm going to present in the next half an hour, 45 minutes, is to basically help you understand how to learn fast the DQ Labs way. Now, there are two different modes you can switch on to when you're learning, okay? One is learning for pleasure. Like you like to do something, so you try to learn those skills. And there is no time bound, it's not a time bound activity. So the entire life is with you. Like for example, you want to learn human figure drawing. You can become master at it, and you can take 25 years to master at it. Or like for example, you want to learn Bharatanatyam, like what Poshita has done. You can take years to learn, right? You're doing that activity for pleasure. But when it comes to the exams, right, you got to switch on to a different mode, okay? Now, this I realized in a very hard way. I realized that you should be learning with reason and not with emotion, right? I'll tell you my example. Like when I was doing my architecture, 5 years of architecture, I did that because I want to become an architect, because I really loved what I was learning. Okay, and inadvertently, I was the university top ranker as well, because I never looked into the marks, and in fact, a couple of submissions were very late, but they appreciated my work, and I was the topper of the class, right? But a big jolt happened when I gave this GATE exam for my first time, and I was expecting like to be on the top because I was always been a topper, but I was nowhere. I was not even qualified for that exam. Whereas my classmate, my friend, my good friend, who is Kiran, we were like on the top position. Like he cracked it in the first attempt and he got into IIT Kharagpur to do his master's. And I was like, oh my God, what happened? What did I do wrong? Because I have put all my heart and soul in preparation, but then I flunked. So then I realized that, especially for exams, you can't use your emotions. You got to learn with a reason. What does that mean? For example, an exam has 100 questions. If you know all those 100 questions, without any preparation, you will be the topper. Right? So you don't have to study anything. You just have to know the answers of those 100 questions and you can top the exam. It has nothing to do with my knowledge, my capacity, and etc. What it matters is the way I'm able to tackle those questions in the exam and give them the right choices. And they will feel that, okay, I know all the knowledge, I have all the skill, all the aptitude, ability, and they'll make me the top ranker. But that is not possible in the real life, right? We can't get the question papers upfront, right? So we have to be very cautious on how we are utilizing our X amount of time for this preparation, okay? I want to cite one example of a student who was like preparing with emotion, right? With all her heart and soul. So we did a mock test, and the mock test had a sketch, a theme sketch, where a student will have to draw a window, right? So she has good skills, but she did not draw that sketch at all. When I asked her, she said, sir, I will attempt this later, but first I want to know the various kinds of windows that are available. French window, bay window, casement window, etc., etc. I want to study that thoroughly and then answer this question. So that is what is called as learning with emotion, right? So you want to put in your heart and soul to learn everything nicely and then you give the test. But unfortunately, that doesn't work in these exams, right? So the learning with reason, you need to have a strategy. Strategy for exams. So what does that mean? Fortunately or unfortunately, nobody talks about the strategy for the exams. Even if they talk, they only talk about a very high level strategy. They are not talking about personalized strategy. What does that mean? Now, in our daily lives, if you want to accomplish certain things, we always think or we always plan even before attempting to do it, right? So the parents would know if they are trying to shortlist a house for purchase, you have a strategy in place. First, I need to do this, then I need to do this, then I need to do these checks, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, and then you get into it. If you're investing in stock market, you know there is a strategy, and you use data to make your decisions, right? But when it comes to exams, people don't talk about strategy. Ah, okay, you just take this guide and study whatever you wish. That's wrong. So you need to have a strategy, not a generic one, but a personalized one. And how do you get a personalized strategy? When you are preparing, you always have to keep a track of your progress. You need to know where you are currently, what you do, what you need to do next, and what you have to do in the exam, right? I always love to take the example of cricket for getting a strategy, because there are a lot of similarities in exam preparation as well. So there are certain things that happens before the game and certain things which happens in the game, right? So before the game, all the players practice, they keep a track of the progress, the strengths, weaknesses, and nowadays there is technology, data science, that kind of, you have these cameras and sensors in the bats, balls, wickets, and in the gear that you use, that kind of sends all the data and feeds the data back to you to help you understand what is your best batting position, what is the worst batting position, how you got to tweak your strokes and etc. Right? So you're not making, the players are not making decisions based on their assumptions, but through data science. Right? So that is the thing that happens before the game. And during the game, let's say you're a batsman and there's a bowler bowling the balls at you, and you have to make a decision whether to play that ball or not. Similarly, like in MCQ tests, you have 100 questions. Minute after minute, a question is posed at you, and you got to decide, first take a decision whether to answer this or not, play this ball or not. If you want to play this ball, how would you play? What stroke? First, you need to identify whether it's a googly from the question setter or not, right? And then you got to play your game. So you need to track your progress, and you need to know these three specific things: where I am, what are my skills, abilities, strengths, and weaknesses, what I need to do next. There are, let's say, 100 topics, but which topic I need to study first, that you got to know. Because there is no point by just going with assumptions, saying that, okay, I think I'm really bad in this particular subject because I've not spent too much time, so let me spend time in that. That is not the right way to do. I'm going to tell you how at DQ Labs we help you get these three pieces of information, right? And then how should I answer in the exam? Like what questions I need to skip, what questions I can go for elimination process. Now, when you're answering a question, there are only three ways you can answer a question, right? I'm talking about multiple choice questions, right? First is the intended method. What is that? The intended method is either by using knowledge, formula, reasoning, or analytical ability, logical ability. So every question has a specific way to solve a problem and get the answer. So that is the intended way. There's a first method. If the first method fails, then you try to eliminate the answer choices, right? So let us say you solve this problem and you got an answer of 10, but the answer choices there are like 200, 300, 400, or 100. So we are very way off. So there's something has gone wrong in your calculation, so you don't have time to go back and solve it. So what would you do? You'll choose the elimination method. Okay, maybe this is not, maybe this is the answer. So that is the second method. So let us say you have seen the question and the answer choices, you have no clue. You have never heard of that question, neither the answer choices are not familiar. So what would you do? You would say Jai Matadi and then you pick random choice. Right? These are the only three ways that any student or any person in the entire world can answer. There is no other way. Now these MCQs are 100-year-old stuff, right? So initially it was paper-based. Then with the use of technology, they have made it online, digitally. And after that, there is no innovation that has happened, right? So what we have done is we have re-engineered the MCQs to capture the method of answering a question. Now there are so many platforms in the world, very well-known platforms. They have been in the education field for so far, but in terms of MCQs, there was no innovation of any sort. But we have figured that capturing this particular three sets of information will open up a lot of possibilities, and we can give pure data analytics to the student to help them decide what they need to study and what they need not study. Okay? And in fact, I think Dion has also mentioned. Now, we have been testing with this platform since a long time, and we have been getting a lot of results, and we were updating it and upgrading it on a monthly basis, right? In fact, the students who have used our platform last year, if they see our platform now, they'll see something completely new and a new upgraded version of the testing platform, the learning platform that we have created. So we figured that if this is working for NATA, NID, UCET, and CEET exams, the same technology can be used for any other exam in the world. And it is true. It is helping students. So what we have done is we have taken the technology part of DQ Labs, and we have formulated a company called exampley.com. The idea is to help students crack entrance exams easily. In other way, to help students or any learner learn fast through these actionable insights. And we fortunately have also won the NASSCOM's Design for India Award, Design Award 2019. And I feel it's a great achievement because so far the technology invention in edutech space has been to bring the offline activities online. But beyond that, they have not done anything else. But we were the first people in the world to get into the intricacies of answering a question, and we have re-engineered the MCQs, and we are using it in DQH platform, and we are actually giving you these results. So when I say track progress, you should be tracking progress through data science and not by assumptions. And this is what we are absolutely unique in, and no other competitor or coaching center or learning platform does this the way that we are doing, right? So we have these four ways you can measure the progress. One is through radial maps, XP points, progress bar, and suggestions. I'm going to show you how it's going to work. And other important thing to learn fast is to give feedback and take feedback. Generally, students think that to crack an entrance exam, it's like a solo activity. But it is not. You might have realized when you try to explain a concept to your friend or to a group of friends, you learn fast. You, in fact, think about some certain concepts that you have not realized before. So give feedback and take feedback. Now, we have used these principles and created the DQH platform, and we are giving the platform for all the DQ Lab students. Now, I'll show you how this platform can be used. Some of you might already know, but I'll take this opportunity to enlighten the parents and also the students and the faculty here, so that everybody understands how to use it and they can use the potential of what we have created. So this is a typical page. Once you log in, you will be able to see the learn, practice, discuss part of the DQH, and you can also navigate to various entrance exams. okay, like NID, NATA, NIFT. It is showing IAS. We are not giving IAS coaching, but our platform has been used by an IAS coaching center guys for their own students. So that is the reason it is being listed here. But anyway, you can go to NID, UC, Seed, and I'm going to show you what you can do. Let us start off with taking the practice test. Now, even before you start learning for an exam, the first thing that you need to know is to have a strategy. Like, as I told you, you need to understand where you are, what you need to do next, and what you have to do in the exam. So for that, if you have not taken a test, I would highly recommend you to take a test on the practice section. I'll just show you a test that I have already taken.